Welcome at forexcitytrading.com. Right now it is 4 a.m., 35 minutes after 4 a.m. In the morning, Eastern Standard Time. It is 23rd December right now. So let's take a look what kind of important news are coming out today. We are having some information at pound and more interesting news at dollar. So we are having United States coming out with important data. So let's take a look how index S&P 500 is doing. Right now we see the breakout from yesterday. I was saying that it is a classic nice breakout with we didn't see a super strong trend, but medium and small size candles we're saying that we might see a bigger probability of follow through, and it really happened because the probability of the continuation of this movement when we broke out from support resistance level at this rectangle was bigger than taking any significant or smaller breath. So we see market continuing beautiful, even though these are very small and medium candles. We see the right behavior of this market, which nobody wants to sell, or nobody wants to take the profit from those transactions, from those here or from those before. So market stays at some particular level because nobody wants to take the profit. So it is reasonable to stay with the long position. I'm not saying it is smart to come to the market right now at this point, but I'm saying that if somebody has a long position, it might be reasonable to stay with it for a while. I'm not also saying that market can't really take a breath or retracement. Of course it is possible and also reasonable that market go to the downside just for a few moments to take a breath and to see how it's gonna grow for another hours, days, weeks probably. So let's take a look at how currencies are doing. We see at euro dollar we see different situation at pound. Starting with pound at 4 hour chart, we are looking at, we see downtrend and we see lower lows each time and lower highs because it is a reasonable downtrend and the pound's feeling comfortable with those sellers coming lower and lower at this market. The situation in euro dollar is very different because euro dollar wanted to go higher and higher because of this demand we see right there with beautiful green big candles. But then situation happened that pound started to drive euro dollar lower and lower, even though it didn't want to go so low. So the behavior at pound was much stronger, and kind of we could say euro dollar didn't have its opportunity to go higher and higher, even though it wanted to. So the market and the concept was driving this currency down. And right now we see a pound is making lower and lower lows, and we have some opportunities to come in at the market during the day. And really at euro dollar it doesn't look like we are consolidating at this point. I've took a notice, it looks like a small flag or something similar, but the most important is that we don't have any sellers important coming here, and even if they come to the market we see buyers taking over after few hours. So the market is much different than at pound right now. So it is more likely like continuation or finishing of the sellout. I'm not saying that we can't start to accelerate to the downside. It is also possible, of course, because it is a little downtrend right now. But I'm saying that most likely it looks like no big sellers are coming at euro dollar. So anytime when the change when the trend change at pound, it might be shooting higher and higher. That's what it's telling us right now. So please be careful going, coming short to the market, because really euro dollar didn't tell us the recent times that it is strictly in the sellout direction. The unclear situation at euro dollar, unclear trend, drove me to see more interesting situation at pound. That's why we see transaction example, trade example at those point, and another one And we see the third one right here from yesterday. So if I have more time, I will show it to you how it happened. So we have real trade example from yesterday. So let's see how it looked like at 30-minute chart when it see most. When we see most how it happened during the day. Right now we are having some kind of sell-off at dollar and the same at pound. So one driven another. Just after 9 o'clock we see, I mean, a European opening. So we are talking 8 a.m. London time. We see sell-out. So sellers came to the market. We'll see if it's gonna follow through. And looks like at pound. Here we got continuation, little micro continuation pattern of if the price didn't really go through to the upside from 33.93, it should be going lower and lower. Maybe we will see more lows this day, of course. Yesterday it was much more interesting when we were having, let me zoom in a little bit. This situation right here, we had a flag, beautiful pattern, and the European market opened yesterday right here at these levels. So I was waiting for market to show important data 2 hours and a half after a European opening to possible enter the market at short position. Seemed like the market already started to drop before breaking the news, and it was really attractive. But the news were coming out, and the news came out here, and the market drove back for 50 points. So it is important sometimes to wait another half an hour or hour to important news to see what's gonna happen, because coming in the market here might be cleaning us out just for a few pips, even though the market's still going lower and lower afterwards. So the publication, news publication impact has been finishing soon after an hour and a half. And at 30-minute chart, we see an important real account trade example at those levels. So I'm gonna discuss it in a trade example menu. So it is a day before Christmas Eve. I do not expect any important move, I mean important traders coming to the market in the Christmas Eve day or a day before. We can see some movement, some bigger movement to due to lack of liquidity. So please remember that not all the moves are making the big players. Sometimes it is happening that the lack of important trading makes some bigger movement at the price chart. Thank you very much for listening. I hope you see some more interesting trade examples. And I hope to meet you at an online trading program. Thank you very much.